Hello guys. So today's video is, I hope, very aesthetic. I'm gonna be sort of tracing, scratching, tapping on the beauty that is this book. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. For some people, that would be Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. I really hope that you have had a good weekend and are looking forward to the week ahead. If you enjoy this video, please do subscribe to my channel, ASMR Symphony. So I'm going to be flipping to random pages and just doing a bit of reading, tracing, tapping, and I really, really hope you enjoy. Here we go. Here's Harry. His little hands. The snake suddenly opened its beady eyes. Slowly, very slowly, it raised its head until its eyes were on a level with Harry's. It winked. Harry stared, then he looked quickly around to see if anyone was watching. They weren't. He looked back at the snake and winked too. The snake jerked its head towards Uncle Vernon and Dudley, then raised its eyes to the ceiling. It gave Harry a look that said quite plainly, "I get that all the time." "I know," Harry murmured through the glass, though he wasn't sure the snake could hear him. "It must be really annoying." The snake nodded vigorously. "Where do you come from anyway?" Harry asked. The snake jabbed its tail at a little sign next to the glass. Harry peered at it. "Boa constrictor, Brazil." "Was it nice then?" The boa constrictor jabbed its tail at the sign again and Harry read on. "This specimen was bred in the zoo." "Oh, I see. So you've never been to Brazil?" "I don't want to spend too long on any one page. But oh my goodness, how beautiful is it?" Let's keep going. Chapter 5. Diagon Alley. Alley. Diagon Alley. Harry woke early the next morning. Though he could tell it was daylight, he kept his eyes shut tight. It was a dream, he told himself firmly. I dreamed a giant called Hagrid came to tell me I was going to a school for wizards. When I open my eyes, I'll be at home in my cupboard. There was suddenly a loud tapping noise. Aunt Petunia knocking on the door, Harry thought, his heart sinking. But he still didn't open his eyes. It had been such a good dream. Tap, tap, tap. All right, Harry mumbled, I'm getting up. He sat up and Hagrid's heavy coat fell off him. The hut was full of sunlight. The storm was over. Hagrid himself was asleep on a collapsed sofa, and there was an owl wrapping its claw on the window, a newspaper held in its beak. Harry followed Hagrid out onto the rock. The sky was quite clear now and the sea gleamed in the sunlight. The boat Uncle Vernon had hired was still there with a lot of water in the bottom after the storm. How did you get here? Harry asked, looking around for another boat. Flew, said Hagrid. Flew? Yeah, but we'll go back in this. Not supposed to use magic now I've got you. Very sweet. Let's skip ahead. Oh, wow, look at this. Look at Diagon Alley. That's amazing. Wow. Oh, this is so cool. Flourish and blunts. Flourish and blunts. With all the roof. This roof. Wow. A low, soft hooting came from a dark shop with a sign saying Elop's Owl Emporium, Tawny, Screech, Barn, Brown and Snowy. Several boys of about Harry's age had their noses pressed against a window with broomsticks in it. Look, Harry heard one of them say, the Nimbus 2000, fastest ever. There were shops selling robes, shops selling telescopes and strange silver instruments Harry had never seen before. Windows stacked with barrels of bats, beans and eel's eyes, tottering piles of spell books, quills and rolls of parchment, potion bottles, globes of the moon. I guess these are all the ghosts that hang out in Hogwarts. The four houses are called Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw and Slytherin. Each house has its own noble history and each has produced outstanding witches and wizards. While you are at Hogwarts, your triumphs will earn your house points, while any rule breaking will lose house points. At the end of the year, the house with the most points is awarded the House Cup, a great honour. And you've got all these ghosts. Ghost, 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 ghost. And little animal ghosts. Look at the poodle. Look at that little poodle. That's so cute. Love it. Scamander from Fantastic Beasts. Newt Scamander. Newt Scamander. Newt Scamander. Newt Scamander. Guide to Trolls. And troll brain, tiny troll brain, tiny troll brain. Food, nose picking, kittens, violence, keep thinking it's Tuesday. That is incredible, I love that. That is so funny. So that's a forest troll. Troglodytarum sylvaticum. And a mountain troll. Troglodytarum alpinum. Or there's also a troll cleg and a troll wig. On a troll wig, feed on troll earwax, blech, disgusting. The mirror of Erised. The potter smiled and waved at Harry and he stared hungrily back at them. Hands pressed flat against the glass as though he was hoping to fall right through it and reach them. He had a powerful kind of ache inside him, half joy, half terrible sadness. How long he stood there, he didn't know. The reflections did not fade, and he looked and looked until a distant noise brought him back to his senses. He couldn't stay here. He had to find his way back to bed. He tore his eyes away from his mother's face, whispered, "I'll come back," and hurried from the room. So pretty. How about Minerva McGonagall? Minerva McGonagall with her little frock there. Her frock. Probably a toad. A toad. Professor Minerva. McGonagall. Professor Minerva McGonagall. Look at the Forbidden Forest. Wow, that's amazing. Skip ahead. Ah, look at Fluffy. Wow. As the door creaked, low, rumbling growls met their eyes. All three of the dog's noses sniffed madly in their direction, even though it couldn't see them. "What's that at its feet?" Hermione whispered. "Looks like a harp," said Ron. "Snape must have left it there. It must wake up the moment you stop playing. Well, here goes." He put Hagrid's flute to his lips and blew. It wasn't really a tune, but from the first note, the beast's eyes began to droop. Harry hardly drew breath. Slowly the dog's growls ceased. It tottered on its paws and fell to its knees. Then it slumped to the ground, fast asleep. Though these fluffy heads are not fast asleep right now. We've got three mouths. Pretty incredible. Amazing. That's him falling into the devil's snare. Devil's snare. What did Professor Sprout say? It likes the dark and the damp. It's a light of fire, Harry checked. Yes, of course, but there's no wood, Hermione cried, wringing her hands. Have you gone mad? Are you a witch or not? Oh, right, said Hermione, and she whipped out her hand. waved it, muttered something, and sent a jet of the same bluebell flame she'd used on Snape at the pond. In a matter of seconds, the two boys felt it loosening its grip as it cringed away from the light and warmth. Wriggling and flaming, it unraveled itself in their bodies, and they were able to pull free. I'm assuming this was to do with the game of chess. Is the game of chess. That's chess, snapped Ron. You've got to make some sacrifices. I'll make my move and she'll take me. That leaves you free to checkmate the king, Harry. But do you want me to stop Snape or not? Ron. Look, if you don't hurry up, you'll already have the stone. There was nothing else for it. Ready, Ron called. His face pale but determined. Here I go now, don't hang around once you've won. He stepped forward and the White Queen pounced. She struck Ron hard around the head with her stone arm and he crashed to the floor. Hermione screamed but stayed on her square. The White Queen dragged Ron to one side. He looked as if he'd been knocked out. Getting a bit stressful. Let's skip, 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 skip. I won't spend too long on this. Here at the end, we have Neville, Ron, Harry, and Hermione celebrating, 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 because Gryffindor had won. He had never won so much as a point for Gryffindor before. Harry, still cheering, nudged Ron in the ribs and pointed at Malfoy. He couldn't have looked more stunned and horrified if he just had the bodybind curse put on him. Which means Dumbledore pulled over the storm of applause, for even Ravenclaw and Hufflepuff were celebrating the downfall of Slytherin. We need a little change of decoration. He clasped his hands. In an instant, the green hangings became scarlet and silver became gold. The huge Slytherin serpent vanished and a towering Gryffindor lion took its place. Yes. Even though I'm a Hufflepuff, of course. I'm a Hufflepuff. Hufflepuff, Hufflepuff. Then here we have incredible, isn't it? Such an absolutely beautiful, beautiful book. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so, so much for watching and once again indulging my Harry Potter obsession. Or even given you tingles. Have an amazing start to your next week. I'll see you in a few.